10x is do without ecstasy. Do it on the vision, I'ma do you right. Anything you want, I'ma do it all night. Tell me how you want it, you know I'ma make it hot. I'm a nasty little brother, I'ma make it body rock. Baby, I'm a freak.
Painting.
I'm on the young
looking beautiful.
Yeah. Be like me. Yeah.
Me. I like me, yes.
Straight back, brains,
no chance. You know that?
Flex for it, going spend a check for you, turn to break their necks for you, going by the yard for you, take you down the North Shore, wet it with them short shorts, handed in the fourth floor, smashing on the gold boards, this is how we do, rapping with the team, boy, THC the crew is like Batman and Robin, Deadpool and Gavin, Thanos and Goblin, the summer we dropping, and bottles been dropping, and bitches been dropping, the music been dropping, trust me, no option, there's only one option, we keep this shit popping, let's keep this shit dropping, this summer we popping, this summer I'm popping.
Stop this. Stop. Come on. Just as you said, so let me remove it.
Just kidding. For you, maybe I'll remove it.
After the show. They gotta pay.
Felipe's 109 banana split.
We'll be right back.
this life. Well, at least this DJ does.
That was Just Like a Spaceman by Bruce Cameron with Aunt B, Billy James, who also is my publicist, one of them, Glass Onion, PR, and he's done a lot for me personally, so I appreciate him and what he did for my dad. He helped put that record together with my father. They're really good friends, and it ended up being a really awesome thing, so shout out to him.
Buy me a closet, all about profit, cause my topic. Lace in the game, cause I'm a shoe. Bitches is lame, how they
Talking about the fortune of the fucking fame. I'm a rude boy, being a
watching me eat ice cream, you should definitely share this video. I did, I promise, the word green lingerie today. No, he's not gonna pull him out.
I'll pull him out.
No.
If you pay me, pay her. Us.
Lady Leah.
You don't fucking pay me too. No, just pay her. If you pay her, you can see it. And I will personally pull him out.
Hey there, gentlemen. Looking to level up your style game without spending a fortune? Move no further than Bonnie and Clyde's Barbershop, where a stunning $20 fade is just around the corner. Make a statement with your style at 1323 North Academy Boulevard today. Bonnie and Clyde's, we understand the importance of a good haircut. Our experienced barbers are dedicated to crafting looks that speak volumes about your personality and panache. Let us redefine your grooming routine and leave you looking and feeling your absolute best. Call us at 719-574-2659 now to schedule your visit and experience the magic at Bonnie and Clyde's Barbershop, where style meets affordability. Bonnie and Clyde's Barbershop, your go-to for the perfect fade. Hey there, tattoo lovers. Ready to take your body art game to the next level? Look no further than Hellraiser's Tattoo Shop, the one and only horror-themed ultimate tattoo haven in Colorado Springs. Come on out and ask us about our incredible tap-out sessions and other deals for all ink enthusiasts. Our skilled tattoo artists are here to turn your imagination into stunning artwork. Swing by our studio at 1325 North Academy Boulevard and let our creativity leave an everlasting mark on your skin. Dial 719-574-2679 now to schedule your appointment and witness the magic unfold at Hellraiser's Tattoo. Step into the world of vibrant self-expression with Hellraiser's Tattoo Shop. Hellraiser's Tattoo, where your body becomes the canvas of your story.
Hey, this is Leggy Leah and Riley, and you are tuned into Syndicate Empire Radio. That's radio heard from around the world. Sex Diva Talk is brought to you by Hellraiser's Tattoos, Bonnie and Clyde's Barbershop, Analog Beats, The Adult Social Media, BDSMandKink.com, Glass Onion PR, and Metal Devastation PR. Welcome back, everybody. I am Leggy Leah, and this is Riley. We hope that you are all enjoying your weekend and enjoyed that music and enjoyed the sexy commercial. So shout out to Big Bird on the beats for helping me put those together. While we were on break, I was over here enjoying a banana split, and I was like thinking about some shit, right? Because I do that sometimes when I'm sitting here and getting all stoned. And I was really enjoying the fuck out of this banana split, guys. Mm-hmm. It was so good. Like, you have no idea. Shout out Felipe's 109 for that banana split. It's the best in town. Anyways, I feel it's important because I am a role model and I am a public figure and young girls do look up to me. So I am sitting here, like, pretty much in a bikini to, you know, celebrate the luck of a high-rish today and be in body positive, because some of y'all know I have been struggling with my weight. I'm not overweight anymore, but I am definitely on the cusp. So I've definitely lost like 30 pounds, which is amazing still. So I'm super proud of myself. At the same time, it's not about like starving yourself or anything like that. You can't be starving yourself, ladies. It's about moderation, you know, like trying to eat healthier, trying to cut back on certain things, but not depriving yourself of things either. You can't be throwing up, you can't be hiding food, you can't be going without food. It's just not healthy. In fact, when you go without food, you teach your body, that, you know, it's starving itself and they'll start retaining it, and that's just not healthy either, you know? Just not healthy. So you can still eat and be a treat is my point. I was saying that during break. You can still eat and be a treat. Don't starve yourself. You know, you should enjoy life. Life has a lot to offer, even in food. Sometimes that's all we can enjoy because of all we can afford. And these days, we can barely afford that. So
especially in jail.
Yeah.
Like, people in there, that's all you got, you know?
Well, some countries, too, like, they aren't fortunate like us either. So enjoy the little things, you know? You can still eat and be a treat, you know? Don't starve yourself to fit anybody's standard of what you should be. Nobody's you. And, you know, you gotta accept you. Nobody could be you at the end of the day. Fuck society standards. That's what Stoner High Girls is about. Breaking is that stigma about body positivity. You can still eat and be a treat and look good and feel good and be healthy and still fit a standard, your standard. You know, fuck what anybody else thinks. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder anyway, and who's anybody to say that you have to be a size zero and starving yourself to be beautiful? No, you don't have to. You know, some of them girls I know can't help it either, so you gotta lay off of them too. I've been on both ends of the spectrum, so. Lay off the skinny girls. You know, I've been skinny, and I had people tell me I'm not eating enough. I've been thick and been told to fucking put down the food. It's like, you know what? Go fuck yourself. If it ain't hurting anybody, it ain't hurting nobody. The only person I hurt at the end of the day is myself. But when I was going through it, it was a high metabolism thing for me. Like, my son, they can devour some food, too. You see it. They have high metabolism. Me, on the other hand, no. It goes straight to my butt, but I need that booty.
I like it.
Booty is life. So, I just want to remind girls that, you know, don't care what people think. Eat. Fucking, if you're hungry, fucking eat it, you know. Try to be healthy if you can. I mean, I can't. No, nobody's perfect. I was not healthy today. I ate a fucking 109 combo with fresh cut fucking fries and some tacos. And
she ate a whole banana split on camera with a live viewers.
And it was good. And I have zero regrets about that. And you know what my tummy is telling me right now? Thank you. I am so happy that you fed me. And you know what? Even though you just ate, you're still a treat. So, just, I goof around, but I'm dead serious, too. You know, don't starve yourself. You're still fucking beautiful. If somebody's telling you that you're not, you know, look at them closely. Are they up to par? Seriously, like... Because I know it's not the people in the magazines telling you you need to be this way, too. Sometimes it's the people in our lives telling us that we have to fit a certain standard, too. And I get that. So, do what's healthy. Don't kill yourself over beauty. You know, beauty don't have to be painful all the time. Feed your belly. You need it. Even models, we need it. You can't go on a photo shoot and not fucking eat. For real, you'll pass the hell out on set. Can't do that to yourself. Real models honestly eat before they go to a photo shoot. So just keep that in mind. They're not eating those salads. Maybe some of them, but that's an eating disorder. So I like to spread awareness on that. You can eat and still be a treat. Eating disorders because of society, and shame on society for causing eating disorders within people. People should just eat. You're hungry, just fucking eat. For real. For real. It's sad. I've seen a girl go around Facebook, it's like her TikTok reels or whatever, you know, those little videos. This girl is so fucking skinny, and you could tell it's definitely an eating disorder. It's anorexia, and I just gotta say, like, I'm sure a lot of you guys know which videos I'm talking about. It's one in particular. She got millions of viewers, and what disgusts me about it is that the mother is so encouraging about these things, about her.
Girl or something?
Yeah, she's young.
I don't use TikTok. I've never been on.
Well, her reels go around Facebook too.
Yeah, I don't really feel like that too much.
Yeah, well, this girl, she's like super fucking skinny, and like she looks like a skeleton, and she dresses up all pretty and stuff, and she works, does all these things to get all these viewers, and her mom encourages it. But you know, like, it doesn't seem like the mother is really trying to get that girl treatment or help. Like, that girl could be dead next year because she is that...
That's crazy.
...unhealthy. Like, she literally is a walking skeleton.
It's sad.
It is sad.
It's probably... She could be, like, a star.
But some of these parents are, like...
I know how some of these parents
are. Like...
Oh, I know.
It's disgusting. It is, though.
Yeah, it's terrible.
It's terrible. You know, so you can eat and still be a treat. Just remember that your life ain't worth it. You know, fuck what anybody thinks. You'll be beautiful to somebody. you know, but first be beautiful to yourself, you know? Why? Be kind to yourself. You're your number one advocate. You gotta take care of yourself at the end of the day. Even if it's over a fucking banana split and tacos. It was good.
But you're never promised tomorrow anyways, you know? So why not?
Why not?
As long as you're happy with yourself, that's all that matters.
It is. It is. It is. I look good. I don't care what people think. Like I said, I'm sitting here in pretty much a swimsuit on a live video eating this food because I really don't care. I think I look good. You know, and if people don't like it, they really don't have to watch it. Mm-hmm. We could scroll forward. They don't have to listen to my radio show. You don't have to do any of that. But I'll tell you what, I'll keep eating that fucking banana split. You know, on the Felipe's 109 every week. I had $18 in fucking free food credit there today. I'm like, hell yeah. Our bill was half off, needless to say. Ended up being free. So ask me if I have any regrets on that. Hell no. I love free. Free banana splits. Fuck yeah. Sign up for the rewards program. I highly suggest it. Good deal. It is. Girls gotta eat, you know. Can't be fucking passing them off the shoots or on set. I love you. So, yeah, I really have been on both ends of that spectrum, though. I, like, was super, super skinny when I was, like, 13. I was misdiagnosed, and they put me on Ritalin, and it's like I was cracked out
24/7. That happened to me, too. They're the same exact thing.
It's like... Like, I was soaking in, no joke. Like, I looked like death, I felt like death, and they told me that I had anorexia. And I'm like, I do not have anorexia.
They were just giving you vitamins.
I am cracked the fuck out from the medicine that you guys keep telling me I have to take. And I was a foster kid, let's keep this in mind. So, they told me that if I need to start putting on weight... that they were going to put me on feeding tubes and lock me up in the hospital. Yeah.
That's crazy.
And I'm like, but you guys are doing this to me, right? Because that's how underweight I was. I was extremely unhealthy. I might as well have been that girl in the videos I'm talking about. That's how bad it was. And I knew it was the fucking medicine. But they make you take your meds every day. And how do you speak up for yourself? You're 13 years old. You've never been taught to speak up for yourself, and you're just fucking dumped in this fucking group home and abandoned, and people are taking advantage of you left and right, but you don't know better. You don't realize they're taking advantage of you at the time, because you're just a fucking kid, you know? So, I started hiding my medicine in my cheek, and I'd go to the bathroom, I'd spit in the toilet, I'd rinse up my mouth, and about a month later, like, one of the group home counselors was like, see, I told you, if you stuck with it, you'd start putting on weight and feeling normal. I go, what are you talking about? She goes, your meds, silly. I go, I haven't taken them in about a month. Yeah.
Did they keep you off of them?
At that point, yeah, because they realized that, like, I was telling the truth.
Yeah,
you know, that
course.
I was fucking cracked out on that shit. So I ate a lot of peanut butter and jelly, and... peanut butter is full of protein, and I would get a lot of Ensure shakes, and then buy a big, huge jug of ice cream, and I'd make milkshakes with it so it wouldn't taste so bad,
and
I would just sit there, because I wasn't used to getting treats like that anyway, so I couldn't taste the Ensure. I'm like, hell yeah, tasty treat, but it was like, putting fat back on my bones and stuff. It was crazy. But then, like, not a lot of weight, but enough to where I was healthy again, right?
Yeah.
But then I, like, pretty much stayed, like, skinny mini for many years, like, a long time after that. I did aerobics and stuff, I taught aerobics. So I had, like, a six-pack and I played basketball, taught aerobics, so I was really fit. But then when I had two of my kids, I still stayed pretty skinny. I looked like a fucking straw with an olive stuck in it until I had my third. Then I got thick. And it just would not go away at that point. And then, yeah, I get people talking shit on both ends. Yeah, when I was skinny, they talk shit.
Yeah, of course. Somebody's always trying to attack somebody's
insecurities. That was my biggest. I get people talking shit, you know. Yeah, so it's like...
That's why you just gotta live with yourself and realize that 75% of the world is full of shit, so don't listen to nothing anybody says, you know, except for you.
I had to learn that people are reflecting.
Their own insecurities, of course.
You know?
Absolutely. I've dealt with a few people in life that opened my eyes towards that.
So I just try to be, like, I didn't always accept myself in my own skin. I just accept myself in my own skin.
You do a good job of it now.
I'm over here wearing green fucking pretty much bikini.
So the sooner you accept yourself in your own skin, the longer you have in life to accept yourself in your own skin.
Well, you should. Like, you should love yourself.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're stuck with yourself no matter what. People could come and go. If you haven't experienced that, then you need to thank your fucking lucky stars. You've never had to experience that. There's some people out there, like myself or Riley, who have experienced these people coming and going. Family, like, our family's what we make of it. It's just the world that we've lived in. So, you ultimately, if you have lived a life like that, you have to be comfortable in your own skin. You have to love yourself. Because if you don't, you're not really going to make it. Honestly. Honestly, though.
That's true. There's too much humility involved.
You have to love yourself. You got to be your biggest advocate.
You know? Like, no matter what you're doing, like, it makes it real hard if you can't just say fuck what everybody else thinks and not have that. And have enough self-worth to not have that humility.
Oh, yeah. Well, some people have, like, parents, too, that are like, hey, you're fucking up. Where some of us have to be like, shh.
Yeah, we gotta learn.
I think I fucked up. You know, and like, and have to correct ourselves, where our parents would be like, you need to correct that because you fucked up. You know, I taught you better, where some of us too are like, fuck. You know, I feel like I did something wrong. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I need to correct that. I'm not really sure, but my instincts are telling me this. You know, so there really are people out there like that. Like, but there's nothing wrong with it. If you have somebody in your life that is, hey, you're fucking up, that means you're blessed.
Yeah,
it means you're blessed. That's what I mean. You're blessed. You know, so people are going to correct me on my, like, weight. If I am getting unhealthy, whether I'm big or small, I have to correct myself. So ultimately, I have to live in my own skin, too. So what can I live with? You know, can I live with being sick and unhealthy every day? Or am I going to live healthy and happy?
I want to keep on eating cheeseburgers and banana splits.
But at the same time, I got to do that in moderation, and I also recognize that. But that's not an industry standard.
No.
But you should still be able to enjoy the banana splits.
What is the industry standard there? Who made those rules? And how, if I met them in person, how much would I value their opinion? Probably not much at all, you know?
Oh my god, right? Yeah, this is true. But it's okay, you know? Like, I am gonna set the industry standards.
Yeah.
I'm gonna, like, break that shit.
Exactly.
Because, you know what? I want my fucking banana splits, yo. Like, I smoke weed. Give me my fucking ice cream. You know? If I want to lose weight, it's because I, Aaliyah, Lady Leah, want to lose weight. Not because some gig told me I have to be a size 0 to fit in and be ever accepted into these certain gigs. I'll create my own fucking gigs. And, like, what the fuck, you gonna tell me I can't fit in? I won't make myself fit in, but, like, if you tell me I can't do something, I'm definitely going to do it, no matter what.
Oh, I get it.
That's just who I am. It's embedded in me. That will forever be embedded in me. I don't give a fuck.
That's a great quality, though.
It is, right? Like, so, I have to be healthy to myself, but not because the society tells me that I have to look a certain way. Besides, different people, like, have to weigh different things anyway. When you're short, when you're tall, like, what, like, 200 pounds looks on a 5 foot person looks completely different on somebody who's 6 foot tall.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So, people have to remember that, too. Like, when people look at me and I'm like, hey, I'm plus size, they're like, no, you're not. How much you weigh? Doesn't matter how much you weigh. Like, I'm 200 pounds. You're not 200 pounds. That's because I'm 6 foot tall. Why? That's why you say that. But I am a plus size model. I am down with the thickness. Yeah. But I'm okay with that. I don't need to fit. You know, even if I lost, like, 50 pounds, I would still be considered a plus size model simply because of the fact that I am 6'1". It doesn't matter. So, why would I torture myself with starvation or throwing up to fit a standard that is non-existent? Mm-hmm. You know, because 6 foot, it's supposed to look different on me.
You're taller than 6 foot.
I'm 6'1". Yeah.
It's a whole other inch.
It's a whole other inch. I'm 5'13".
5'13".
But, you know, she's healthy. But, you know, I'm not a doctor either, so I want to put that disclaimer out there just in case. So may. But be healthy to yourself. Love yourself. Be your number one advocate, because sometimes we have to be alone in the world and we have to be your number one advocates. It can't be babied. We can't always be coddled. Sometimes we have to tell ourselves things and remind ourselves certain things, because not everybody's going to always be there to tell us those things. So, if you want a fucking ice cream and it ain't hurting nobody, go eat that damn ice cream. You know, don't throw it up. Enjoy that fucking shit. Eat it like it is going out of style, okay? Like, I just sat here in a bikini, my thick ass, eating a fucking ice cream. Why? Because I don't...
Well, there's a foot of snow outside.
There is a foot of snow outside. You know? Most countries see weight as a sign of health. Ah, yeah, I believe that. You know, but America is so fucked up. It is, you know. And that's why we have a lot of girls with mental health issues that deal with their weight or their beauty. You know, a lot of girls don't feel like they fit a standard, and it's really fucking sad, and they end up hurting themselves a lot of the times. So I try to be careful on what I put out there when it comes to my modeling agency, because I want to make sure that girls don't hurt themselves, whether it's their suicide or fucking starvation because they feel they need to lose weight. No, bitch, you're beautiful. And if you do your assignments and you're a SHG model, we're going to put you somewhere. You're going to fit in and it's going to be great, you know? And fuck what anybody else thinks. You know, we have girls on our team that said that they would have never gotten an opportunity anywhere else. But because they came to us, they were able to get that opportunity and do what they love and feel accomplished at the same time. And you see a different version of them at the end of it all. Like, they're one way, one minute when they join, very meek and shy and not very confident. But then when they get going and they see how fun it is and they get a publication, for example, that confidence just forever shines and you see a change in them. I'm always happy to be a part of that. And they don't fit a certain industry standard that society deems as that. But they are creating beautiful fucking artwork. And they have fans and followers of their own, too. Mm-hmm. So it's amazing. You know, and I'm not ever going to stop that. I don't think I ever should. You know? Like, I don't know if it's like that in the music scene. Is it?
when it comes to beauty?
Not really, no. But image does play a part. It plays a part in professionalism, I feel like. But not always, you know, because not having an image can be kind of your image too. So it's just kind of like this, it's whatever fits with everything. It's kind of like everything just has to fit together with music, you know?
Right.
But there is a standard at some, in some way, absolutely. Maybe not even when it comes to necessarily how good you look, but how good the production looks in itself as a whole, you know? Like,
well, I think we should always hold ourselves to a certain standard anyway.
That's what I'm saying. There is a standard.
Respect. You gotta have some self-respect for yourself, so you should always hold yourself to a certain standard. Don't hold yourself to society standards, but hold yourself to a certain standard. Just scream self-respect and confidence. Mm-hmm. You know. But I'd like to shout out our sponsors again and then cut out to some more music.
Yeah.
Yeah? So, yeah, let's shout out, let's see, Hellraiser's Tattoos, Bonnie and Clyde's Barbershop, which is over there at 1325 North Academy Boulevard in Colorado Springs. Analog Beats, you can find them on Google or Facebook or IG. TheAdultSocialMedia.com, sign up today, it's 18 plus. BDSM and Kink.com, get all your toys there and at, you know, very affordable prices, it's awesome. And Glass Onion PR and Metal Devastation PR, thank you for your sponsorship. We'll be right back, guys. Hope you are enjoying your weekend and hope you are enjoying the set.
Ask how life, I'll say it.